Hi, and welcome to Macworld UK's guide to running Windows on your Mac. You can run Windows on any Mac that's got an Intel processor, which means that if your Mac was made in 2006 or later, it's more than likely that you can run Windows on it. Of course, the question is, why would you want to run Windows on a Mac? OS X is a brilliant operating system. But the benefit is that you can run Windows as well as OS X on your Mac. You might, for instance, work in an office where everybody else uses Windows. Well, there is a benefit to be able to be on the same platform as them. And finally, if you're a gamer, you might find that there are more games titles available more quickly on Windows PC than they are on Mac. Again, being able to run Windows on your OS X Mac means that you can play those games in their native format. So, there are two ways that you can run Windows on any Mac. The first one is virtualization. The benefit of virtualization is it allows you to run Windows as a window within OS X. So you can just boot up your Mac as normal and maybe have in your dock Windows almost like a program, and then you open it up and then the full Windows operating system is there. That's the good part of it. The bad part of it is it's marginally more complicated. It costs money typically because you have to pay for the third-party software. And also, what it means is that you're actually running two operating systems from the same hardware. So you can find the performance suffers because your processor's having to run two operating systems. But that's virtualization. Much the simpler way of running Windows on Mac is to use Bootcamp. Now, Bootcamp is built into OS X, and it's much simpler to use, and you don't need to buy anything other than your Windows license because Bootcamp exists on your Mac already. So what we're going to do now is show you how to use Bootcamp on your Mac. You will need, first of all, you need to have Windows. So you need to have some kind of installation media. You need to either buy a DVD if your computer has a DVD drive. We're using a MacBook Air here, so it doesn't. So we've got a USB drive with our version of Windows on this that we've purchased and downloaded. It's better to use USB 3 if you can and if your machine will accept it, because it's quicker, and anything you can do to speed things up here will help. Similarly, you need to have a good web connection. We'd recommend using Ethernet rather than Wi-Fi if possible, but really it's just the best quality of connection that you need. One final point is that if you're installing Windows 7, you need to use a USB 2 drive rather than a USB 3 drive. That's because Windows 7 doesn't out of the box support USB 3. Windows 8 does. It'll just take a bit longer, that's all.
Here's how to use Bootcamp to run Windows on your Mac. First, you'll need a Windows installation media. You can create this using Bootcamp. The easiest way to do this is to purchase and download Windows from Microsoft's website and leave the ISO file on your Mac desktop. You'll need a USB drive. You could also use a DVD if your Mac has a DVD drive. Boot your Mac and navigate to Applications, Utilities, Bootcamp Assistance. Bootcamp will find the Windows ISO and prompt you to create a bootable disk using the USB drive. Then Bootcamp will download Windows support software. This is usually a few hundred megabytes and will take a few moments. Next, you'll be prompted to set the partition size, that is, the amount of storage you will dedicate to Windows. You'll need at least 20 gigabytes, but we suggest you select as much storage as possible. One good option is to divide your hard drive equally between OS X and Windows. You now have to set Windows preferences, such as the type of install and the language used. You'll be asked where to install Windows. Point it at the Bootcamp partition. You'll be prompted to format the disk. Do so, ignoring any warnings. All of this will have taken some time, but now Windows will install. This will take around 15 minutes, after which your Mac will boot into Windows. The first time Windows boots, you'll be prompted to download and install the Bootcamp drivers. By default, Bootcamp will set up your Mac so that you always boot into Windows, and you have to select to boot into OS X. You can change this in the preferences. Either way, by holding down Option during boot up, you can select into which OS to boot, Windows or OS X.
That is how you install Windows and run Windows on a Mac.